Thank you, Wycliffe, breaking it down for us there on the scoreboard. And of course, regarding Ababu's stint and who should come in, let's take a look at what you think, you the stakeholder, you the fan, beginning with what went down in Lamu. Take a look at what Kenyans think.
Consider legendary. I want a legend, because a legend, in the first place, he has the feelings, he has the right qualifications, because he knows what sports is. So he will always make good decisions when it comes to appointing or naming the what procedures should have in the office. This story of taking politicians, you take a politician to give him a portfolio of sports, is what has failed this country.
Kenya imegawanywa kwa sehemu nyingi, na Kenya na wachezaji wazuri wa maana ambao tunaweza tukaingia paka kwa World Cup. Lakini shida ambayo inatokea, watu wanaangalia region moja peke yake. Kwa hivyo kwanza huyo atakayechaguliwa awe ni mtu ambaye hana biasness, mtu ambaye yuko fair, mtu ambaye anaweza kuwapitia maeneo yote ya Kenya hii, county zote, aende aweze kuangalia vipaji vya vijana wetu.
Kwa mtu ni kiongozi wa michezo, yeye mwenyewe hata hajui hiyo michezo nini. Ndio maana huko mashinani wote tuko na changamoto nyingi sana. Kama sisi marifaria hatutambulikani, hatujulikani, vibali vyetu pia si za kutosha kuchezesha huko juu, na tukijaribu kufuatilia pengine yule kiongozi mwenyewe mpaka apushie sana ndo atusaidie, kwa sababu ni kitu yeye mwenyewe hata hakijui. Kama ingechaguliwa kiongozi ambaye anajua tayari ameanza kuanzia mashinani paka pale mali amefikia, so kama yeye atakuwa ni mkubwa tayari anajua mali mimi nilikuwa, kuna wenzangu wako huko, anaweza kutusupport vizuri sana na huyu mpira ukainuka sana Lamu County.
Awe ni waziri ambaye ana weledi wa mambo ya sports, kwa sababu mara nyingi tunakuta tunachaguliwa watu ambao hawaelewi mambo ya sports, na unakuta wanaharibu, mara kunakuwa na ufisadi na mambo mengi ambayo hayaeleweki.
Achague manager, sio mwanasiasa wala mtu wa michezo, manager ambaye anaweza kutembea Kenya nzima akaangalia kama ni mkate wa sports uganyo wa Kenya nzima anaenda kila kona. Tunasikitika sana minister ambaye ametolewa Babu na Mwamba miaka miwili, how consider Pwani region kuwa na stadium hata moja.
Nataka kuchukua fursa hii kusema kwanza, Mr. President, you have done a very good thing kuondoa huu mjamaa, because tukiangalia kwa sport ya kukua kitu hakukua na kitu kikubwa kinafanyika huko. Tukiangalia timu kama Harambee Stars, they were playing field ya nje wakati tunafaa kuwa na field huku yetu yenye walikuwa wanafaa wachezee huko. Sasa nataka kuchukua hii fursa, Mr. President, uone mtu naeka huko wa maana, mtu mwenye anaweza saidia sports ziendelee mahali penye zilikuwa zinaenda.
Kitu nilikuwa nataka niombe rais ni arudishe yule siasa wa sport hapo na Mwamba, kwa sababu yeye tulikuwa tumeona utendakazi wake ilikuwa vizuri. Like, alikuwa ameanza kutukuzia matale nduko reserve, alikuwa ameleta vijana pamoja. So kitu naomba rais tu ni kuturuchesha ule rais ule Ababu na Mwamba.
Leo sasa hivi rais ameotupiria nje wote hivi. Tunataka achague CS mwenye anaelewa sports ni nini kwanza. Anaelewa since anaweza support vijana from the grassroots wakipanda wakienda juu. Sasa hivi tukienda at the stadium senye vijana wanachezea games ni mbaya sana. Sasa hii kama mimi ni mkisika, sasa hii kama hii kisi stadium hapa yenye iko hapa. Sasa hii game inachezwa moja, mvua ikinyesha tuko na matope hapo. So tunataka CS mwenye atakuchaguliwa, achaguliwe ni mwenye anaangalia maslahi ya vijana na anaangalia chinzi anaweza saidia vijana wapande kwenda juu, kwa sababu vijana wako na taranta mingi hapa nje yenye hatuna mwenye anaweza tusaidia kukusa hizo taranta na tuweza kwenda mbele kama vijana to develop.
So kwa vitu zile pia at least naomba tu ichukulikia, yani tuadamie tu kama unajua, si kama wengine unapata tuko na talanta, kama mimi sasa niko na talanta lakini sasa sina mtu wa kunishika mkono nikanishike mkono at least ni perform talanta yangu nione venye naelekeza kwenda pale.
Currently, it's not what we expect as sportsmen and women. Ababu na Mwamba started well when he came in, but in between he got lost of everything. As a football lover and somebody who believes that football can pay, I don't think the minister gave his all in terms of ensuring that we get the best players and the best league in Kenya.
Corruption should not be considered. Someone who is corrupted should not be considered in having the sporting activities. Secondly, we need to consider age. Age-wise, sports need a very youth and a talented person who knows what is sport, what sports entail, and the entire society, an entire community, an entire government should consider somebody who is young and very energetic.
The president should consider somebody who must have played football, boxing, tennis, or an athlete to be the minister for sports. Somebody who knows at least what sport it's all about.
I would love to see a sport docket where person who understands sport deeply is in that, is taking that position.
So we want a younger person who can move around, develop youth football, because football is about talent that is to be identified from the younger age. We need we need football academies in each and every county for us to be a football powerhouse or a boxing powerhouse or a tennis powerhouse.
Young men are really working hard to see that Kenya good, get good thing in terms of sport, and there are nobody who can lift them up, who can pick them and support them.
The challenges players or the entire community of sports are facing. But again, we need to consider eligibility criteria of qualification, like according to academic portfolios. We also need to see somebody who's enlightened and have information on background of issues of sport or sport.
Well, those are Kenyans there giving their perspective on what they expect on the new sports seers. Orandi, real quick, you've listened to what Wananchi say.
Yeah.
Maybe from where you sit, what probably do you expect the president to address when he picks the new man?
I think the president should now, it's high time that he opens his eyes wider from the wake of what has been happening and get someone who can really deliver, not rewarding people that he knows, not rewarding people that he knows that will assist him in future, maybe in, when it comes to the next election, but someone, a technocrat actually.
A technocrat.
Yes, who will actually knows what a sport, how to run a sports ministry, what a sports ministry needs and how to treat people, how to look for funding, how to... as in that PR aspect of it when it comes to the sport, running of the sports ministry.
Swila, as I add what he's saying, yeah. You know, as we talk about sport, we're not talking about football alone. Basketball, yeah. We're talking about cricket, we're talking about tennis, we're talking
hockey.
All these, and then if you look at their federations, they're dead. There's a statement that one of the CS said that if you are holding a political seat, you're not supposed to be even in the federation of these sports in industries. Whereby, if you look basketball, we have an MP who is our treasurer. So for me, I think as much as we are looking, most people are on into football. Let's look about even to other sports. Whereby even in infrastructure, it's dead.
Absolutely. Nothing. You see, in 1 minute, the main challenge or the elephant in the room, whom the panelists have not really tackled, is the looming FIFA shadow over Kenya. Now, Mwamba tried to navigate around it, but I think he was diplomatic over the fears of the ban. We have our girls have already qualified for the Women Under 17 World Cup. We are hosting AFCON in 2027. If at all we get our stadia ready. I think that's the biggest fear every stakeholder, most of football, has. What do you think probably the next CS gonna do regarding this?
That's why I said from the beginning, Swila, I felt former Waziri Amina used to really be briefed a lot so that she understands what really happens in sports. That was my thinking. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and Ababu was different. He showed that he was understanding what was happening. Now, you need a person who comes and has all the facts, all the basic facts and knowledge about what is happening, for example. Like, when you are hosting that AFCON, what do you need? You understand? For example, Ababu and the benefit of being in the campaign, of bringing it here. And now the person who is coming to take over should be able to understand from the beginning what is needed. Because, Swila, you've given a very good example. When Ababu came to office, the first duty was to negotiate with the FIFA so that Kenya is readmitted to international football.
Yeah, after the suspension.
And some people are saying he has failed because of not raiding on FKF and all that re-elections. But people are forgetting that there was a catch-22 here. Because he wants to ensure that still we are playing international football. Like you mentioned, we have the girls going for the World Cup under 17. And still, we are marching towards 2027, AFCON. So it was not easy for him to make some radical decisions that would have even attracted FIFA ban again. So basically, even as we talk about some of those big projects, and people are forgetting, by the way, we have the Olympics even now. You know, it's not easy when you have a CS, flagging off with the president, the team, and a few days later, that person is dismissed. So it also has some mood on the athletes and all that. I want to believe so. Of course, I want to believe the managers and the coaches are doing a good job to make sure that the athletes concentrate on what is the job at hand. But basically, the person who is coming here should be a person who needs very little brief
regarding
and
sports.
Get the ground running.
I would go with the common phrase in Kenya that the next CS should listen to the ground. And that is why I said Ababu started very well, but he got detached. Why? He left behind the population. What is the population saying? What do we need? You see, you cannot promise a population that by September 2024, Buhungu Stadium will be ready for CHAN. But when you go to Buhungu, it's a grazing ground. Mm-hmm. You know, that is what, if you give a promise, let the next CS or the next CSS who will come be truthful. Sema, Buhungu Stadium will be completed in 2025 August. Hata kama utapigiwa kelele, but that is the truth.
In short, you give realistic targets.
Give realistic targets. Because even as we speak now, Talanta Stadium, they gave big promises. The president will be inspecting it in 2 weeks. Is he doing it? Every 2 weeks. So those are the things. And Kenyans are very. Kenyans are a very sharp population. You might think they are foolish, but they are following through what you're doing.
Absolutely.
Talk about Woodley talk about City Stadium. I remember when Talanta Hela was the groundbreaking of Talanta Hela, he was given a mandate to oversee even those the stadium, the county stadium that needs to be done, to be constructed.
Upgraded, yeah.
But again, now you saw the pictures. I sent them on the group. Like, there's nothing that has been done on the Woodley Stadium. There's nothing that has been done on the City Stadium. Now that we are overusing the other three stadiums that we have here in Kenya, all the matches are being played there. Everything is being played there. In the next maybe 1 year or a few months, they will be worn out.
Absolutely.
Where are we going? Where are the players going?
The state of stadia. And of course, today we're asking you, what should the president consider in picking a new sports cabinet secretary? You can text us to 2422, hashtag Sporty Monday. We will be sampling some of them shortly. At this point in time, we take a brief commercial break, but when we return, we go to our quick fire segment. The guest already here, Bethuel Oduo, historian, author, and a sports commentator, as well as NOC Secretary General Francis Mutuku, will be talking to us. That's on the other end of the break. Stay tuned.